Now an easy thing for you to do in iMovie to create some dramatic effect is to use freeze frames. Freeze frames basically stop the action, create a still frame in the video, and then continue it afterwards. So for instance here I've got this surfing video and you can see it's just a surfer and then the wave surrounds them here. It'd be neat to freeze the frame right before they are enclosed in the wave. So right around here. So I'm going to click there and you can see it puts the marker right where I want it to. Now to add the freeze frame I go to Modify, Add Freeze Frame. And you can see what it does here is it creates this little spot where it freezes. You can see as I roll over it freezes there. This entire area marked by the hand is frozen and then it continues right here. And I can adjust the freeze frame point by dragging one of these two circles here. So I can actually drag this circle in to have a shorter freeze frame or out to have a longer freeze frame. So let's create a shorter freeze frame there. If I put the cursor there and hit space you can see it plays through, pauses, resumes. So I can do really cool things by adding some music here or maybe just recording a voiceover here with commentary just talking about what's going on in this freeze frame. This is great for sport shots, you know, to freeze just as the ball's going in the basket or the batter's about to hit the ball, that kind of thing. Even after volleyball spike or something, you can put some really cool dramatic effect, get that nice freeze frame in there, and have it continue. And you can see it keeps it all together as one object here in the timeline. So it's very easy to move around and edit and things like that. Now if you want to do something a little extra, it's easy to cut out this portion here. If I click on the hand, I get the start and points for the freeze frame. And you can see it kind of locks to them as I move my cursor there. I can click there, do Command-B for split, select it again, easily position my cursor here and Command-B for split. So now I've split it into three clips, before, freeze frame, and after. And there's really no change to the video itself. It looks the same, except now there are three separate clips. So I can select this one and say apply a filter to it. And now I've got it filtered. And you can see it changes color and then goes back. So it's kind of a nice thing that you can do by adding a filter to only the freeze frame and not the video before and after.